Hey, good morning, everyone. It's Noah, the home inspector. When I'm not out inspecting houses, I've actually got a second job. I started at Greenville Soft Wash and Pressure Cleaning Services. Today is Saturday. We're trying to catch up out here doing a wash. So we did some of this wash on Monday. That's why it looks so bleachy, clean, white, is because we did a post-treat with the bleach, and it cleaned everything, killed all the algae after we did a pressure wash, flat surface cleaning. So today we're going to finish this back patio, so I was going to show you that. Before I do, I wanted to give you a quick overview. A lot of people's been asking about this trailer and what I built over the wintertime of 2021. So I wanted to give you a quick overview and show you what's we got going on here. Okay, so here's the trailer. I had the sign made for the back. This is both companies on the back, and it just gives some of our deals and discounts and our contact numbers at the back. Before you can buy any of this pressure washing equipment, you have to go buy these shoes. Everybody on TikTok and Instagram and YouTube has these hook shoes. These are waterproof shoes used for boating stuff and fishing. So you have to buy that to join the club. So start with that. So pretending the water is coming in the house, this is my freshwater hose reel. This is a Cox reel. So all the water comes in, it goes through the thing there and it comes up and it feeds the buffer tank. So this is the $50 special buffer tank that I got on Craigslist, just like everybody else. It's a pretty good size tank. I don't even know. Looks like it's a 225, 250 gallon tank. So the buffer tank goes there. It comes out the bulkhead on the bottom. I've got a split on it, a T, so this can come out and fill up. If you have to have a little wash bucket for degreaser or anything like that, you can fill up a little 5 gallon bucket here on the side. Otherwise, the water comes in, goes through a 1-inch threaded or 1-inch braided hose, comes up, does a filter, and then it goes right into the pressure washer. This is a Comet pump, Honda engine. This is 4,000 PSI mounted to the side. Got that from Northern Tool. Most important thing is belt driven. Belt driven will pull water from this tank. If you have a direct drive, it will not. You will have to have a secondary pump to push water. But with this amount of water in here pushing down, and it goes into here and it pushes up to here, if you can just get the water to here, the pressure washer will pull the water the rest of the way, and it works absolutely perfect, no problem at all. So as the water goes into the tank, you can also come off. This is a secondary hose coming off, and this feeds our soft wash system. Here's the mixing valves. So you got clean water coming in here. This is your bleach, and this is your surfactant. So surfactant comes right off the secondary tank here. Mix a jug with about 15 gallons of water. That comes off, and it breaks off. So I've got another hose coming off here that's a T, where I can pull off of that 5 gallon bucket that I mix over there, a secondary mix, I can pull off of that. There's a drop stick. So I pull off of that, and I can run something else instead of having to use a surfactant. But the surfactant comes in. I've already caught a lot of crap from different people because I use the same size hose for every single different mixture. But I mean, this can all be changed, guys. So right now we can go, 100%, zero. You can tone it way down on the surfactant and just crack it, or you can go full surfactant or whatever you want to do. But caught a lot of crap because apparently other people use tiny little hose for the surfactant, a little bigger hose for the bleach, and then a big hose for the water because you never really turn the water off. But I just use the same hose for all of it. I think this is either 3/4 or 5/8 all the way in. I want to say 3/4. So all that comes into here, goes down, pulls off of that. There's another line that comes across the bottom, and then it pulls off my 55 gallon drum of bleach, or SH, whatever you call it. So that runs into here. I've got two pumps going right now. These are both the bigger pumps, the 7, I think, gallons per minute. A lot of people are using the 5.5, and they said, oh, when I get the money, I'm going to get the 7. So I just went ahead and bought the 7 because I don't want to have to upgrade later. Now, you see two pumps. I've only got one running. So it goes in through the mixer, comes out here, goes into the pump, pushes the pump out into, you have to have an aluminum hose reel. So this is the Titan. Finally found it down at North Georgia Airless. So this is the aluminum Titan hose. And then this is your poly hose coming off here with the quick connect fitting, and we'll spray handle there in the truck. The reason why I have two is that when this one goes down, because it's going to go down, the bleach eats up the diaphragm and all that if you don't keep it washed out. But when it goes down, I've got easy switch here. This is already pre-wired.
Got power here. That works. Got power here. That works. So when this goes down, disconnect, disconnect, move it up, connect, connect, and then back out you go. So it's real simple. If I get in a bind, I'm out working, and that way I can keep on running. I did buy the trailer from this guy up in Lyman, South Carolina. I forget what size this is. I think it's like a 7x16 or something. It's just big enough to fit all my stuff, and it's big enough to go inside my subdivision garage. So this is exactly the only size that I can fit inside of my garage. Most important thing for me is I read a lot of guys run out of battery. So I've got two batteries hooked in, series or parallel. I have to look it up and put it in the text. But I've got both of those running, so it gives me the double length of battery usage. I don't need amperage, I need length. So that gives me plenty of time. And then I've got the charger already hooked into it here. So when I go back home, I put on the drip charger, trickle charge or whatever it's called, and just plug it back in, let it charge. Charges in plenty of time. So on this job, I don't think I need the water. I accidentally showed up on this job the first time and we washed all this and we washed this and we washed all this going over there on just the buffer tank. Unknown to me, there was no water coming off this house. So I had everything hooked up, but it wasn't refilling my buffer tank. And I was able to wash everything with just the buffer tank. So I think we're gonna do that again. At this point, I just have to do the back here. So let me show you what we're going to do here in the back.
At the end of every single job, we take our hoses, especially anything that has bleach or surfactant, is it, and we wash it out. This is 100% water, and we're cleaning our pumps, we're cleaning our hose. As you can see, it will rust up very quickly. It's very corrosive stuff that we use, so at the end of every job, we do a complete wash of at least the pump, keep the pump good and clean. So I've been holding it here now for about 3 or 5 minutes. So I'm just doing a flush and getting all of our stuff clean. I've also hosed off the trailer, kept everything clean on it. We've already got some stuff where the trailer has touched with bleach and it's already starting to rust and cause some ugly spots.
So as you can see, we have some areas of rust that have already started to accumulate. This is a brand new trailer, so that's how corrosive and fast this could happen to your trailer. When I was working here, this grommet actually slipped off the bracket, so I've got to go home and fix that. And when this whole thing shifted, it actually detached my ground. I've got everything grounded here at one point going back into the battery, so I had to get the vice grips and tighten that back up and hold it just so I could get through with this job. And we're going to go home and fix all this back again, but it's very important to have tools out in the field and be able to do your repairs. I just didn't have any of these electrical connections, so I just had to make do with the vice grips. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to follow along. Catch you later.